Additional discovery, Veeam Games Inc. disclosed that they have 1,256 virtual machines in Ottawa. They have a mix of Windows and Linux virtual machines, but the exact ratio is still unclear. They leverage a data collection tool that provides both VMFS data footprint and in-guest data footprint. They are now asking you to size the Veeam components. What step can you take? Okay, let's take a look at the answer options here. Option one, use the in-guest data footprint as source data capacity and assume a conservative 10% change rate to calculate backup repository requirements to meet the desired retention. It doesn't sound bad, but if we go back up again, what does it actually tell us to do? Size the Veeam components. So there's more. It's all of the Veeam components. So we'll have to take a look at the remaining ones. Option two, use the VMFS data as source data footprint and assume a conservative 10% change rate to calculate backup repository requirements and proxy core count. Okay, well, both of them are talking about 10%. This one is talking about in-guest data versus VMFS data. Okay, so some differences. Plus, it's up here, the backup repo versus backup repo and proxy core. Some variances in what we're actually answering here. Use the VMFS data footprint as source capacity and divide that number by the allowed backup window in seconds. Use that throughput number as a base to calculate the required global number of Veeam proxy cores for incremental backup. No, that's actually not how we calculate that. So I think this sounds like it's Straxer, right? This is almost like that video some of you may remember that I did about how to pass your exam with this Harry Potter themed example. Basically, it's throwing some information at us, which we start to think, oh, I've done proxy sizing. There was something about how much data I need to process, and there was some sort of throughput number, and so on. But this is missing some stuff, right? Because first of all, it's talking about incremental backup. So somewhere we would need to divide by the throughput number that we had, the known processing speed that we have for incremental versus divide by 100 if it was a full. And that's not a part of this answer option here. So I'm going to say number three is definitely a distractor here. Let's see, number four, use the in-guest data footprint as source capacity for Windows virtual machines and VMFS data footprint for Linux virtual machines. Well, that's already strange. Why would we want to do that differently? Well, it could be, for example, that for Windows, you might be thinking, oh, we have that feature, BitLooker, so maybe it can exclude deleted blocks. And for that reason, using in-guest data footprint would be more accurate somehow. And we don't have that for Linux, so maybe we should use it for Linux. Well, the real question to ask before you start doing something like that is, what are the requirements to use this feature? That would be to use NTFS, for example. Now, if we go over to the page here, we can actually take a look, and we would need to start shifting through all of this data here, or we could try and search a little bit. Let's see if we search for NTFS. There's nothing about that. ReFS, no. Something about files, no. So we would essentially start to have shifting through all of this data here. Let's see here. Can we see something about the file systems? I don't know. Oh, all VMs reside on NFS data stores. Okay. Let's see here. Interesting. Let's see. That's technical requirements, nothing about that. No, it doesn't really say anything about which exact file system that it's using. So I'm gonna when it says VMFS here, I think what we're really talking about is virtual machine level data, and not necessarily VMFS data store data here, to avoid any confusion here. So we don't know what file system it is. Of course, we could make some sort of assumption here and say we assume that it's doing that, but I don't think necessarily that's the best way to do it. The other problem is, if you use ingest data, what if it has, let's say, for example, some mapped drive of some sort, iSCSI, and here I'm thinking both of Windows and Linux, and using ingest, you might get some varying numbers there as well. So generally, I would recommend using the VM level data here. So if we take a look, there's a couple of things, right? Should we use ingest versus not ingest? I think we should use non-ingest or VM level data. Secondly, we wanted to size these components here. Now, there's a couple of things that we need to size. Obviously, we need something to pull the data out. We need some place to store it. We need a backup server as a minimum. There's nothing here that lets us size the backup server, but as a minimum, we also need to size the proxy here. So if we look at these, which one is actually going to do that? Well, this one is only repository. Let's see here. This one is doing both. This is only doing the proxy. And this is only doing the repo. So since we want to do at least the repo and the proxy, I am going to go with this option here, where we use the VM level data as the source capacity. No, not this one. I'm going to go with this one here. Sorry about that. VM level data, and we'll add the 10% assumed change rate, and we'll use that as the basis for calculating backup repo requirements and proxy core count.